Hey guys, I'm LB, and you remember when I said we could never use a clone of this thing? I don't know what I was thinking. Clearly, we have the clone right here. So yeah, we are back playing the Talos Principle community maps. This is the fourth dimension, we are in the puzzle Eclipse, and we are going to solve it. I don't know what I was thinking, so let's get started, right? We go around, get the panel, the thing, the holder thingy, whatever you want to call it. We got it, awesome. Real quick, I need to get the red thing. I mean, set that guy up. Do it. We will set this guy up as usual. Okay. Let's see, so. Now we've got that set up. So now what we want to do is jump on ourselves again. Oh my gosh, there's so much jumping on ourselves in this. Because we gotta set up the red guy first, and then we can do this all over again to set up the blue guy. Okay, set this guy up, as per usual. And then the clone. This guy will become the clone. And we will use... We will create the midpoint here by the ladder instead. Okay. So, let's think about this. We pick up the guy on the left, run around, we jump on ourselves after we've placed it with the blue where it needs to go, and then we walk here. And then we just kill time, basically. Actually, no, we don't want to kill time, we want to... Right, we need to alternate. You do this. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And we'll just do this a couple times and hope that we don't die. Alright, that should be good. Sure hope this works. Alright, we gotta take this. And then what we do is we place this here without connecting it to anything. That was my mistake. Come on. Jeez, I know I wasted a lot of time just sitting here, but come on. There we go. Alright, so now, we take this guy, connect it, and you see, the midpoint is here now. We have done it. Right, so now he's gonna switch them for us. Oh crap, I died. Oh, gotta do all that again. I hate these puzzles with a passion. These things right here, I hate them so much. I do not know what was happening with the sound there, but that was something special. That gives you an idea of my rage for these puzzles. Oh, actually, I forgot to show you guys something. I discovered something, which I think is absolutely hilarious. Let's take a short break from that puzzle that's really annoying me. And we'll go to another puzzle that's really annoying me. One that I've already solved. I want to show you guys something funny that happens if you position this thing just right. So if you stand on one side of a barrier, and you jam the barrier in such a way that the jammer ends up on the other side, it takes a couple attempts, but... Look at this! A dev thinks that you're cheating the game, and tries to fix it. And depending on your positioning, this can go on like 3 times or more. 2 or 3 times or more. Wow, this is the longest one I've seen so far. I haven't seen it go 4 times. Now 5 times? Oh my gosh, it's still going. Wow, I really bugged out the game this time. How many times is it gonna go? Because it usually ends after like 2 or 3 times. So basically, this is a feature of the game where if you try to push a jammer across a fizzler that it's jamming to try and cheat and get it on the other side that way. Wait, fizzler, no, barrier. If you try to push a jammer across the barrier that it's jamming, the game thinks that you're trying to cheat, and so one of the devs programmed that bug fix in where his character comes in and repositions it back for you. But the thing is, the detection is a bit screwy, because I started on one side of one that was already powered off and just placed the jammer on the other side, but also jamming it. And that triggered the game's detection. It's, quite something special. Quite interesting. Alright. Let's get out of here and go back to that other puzzle now that we've had that brief intermission. La-di-da-di-da! Let's be going. Whoa, what the? What happened there? I like landed on the wall or something? These graphics are kinda bugging out, but whatever. Alright. Stop that. Okay. Okay, what next? Right, we have to go over the wall. And I really hate this puzzle so much. Eclipse, why? Alright. so that's set up now. Now is the last part. The final countdown. Oh my gosh, I just want this to be over so much. At least, it's not nearly as bad as Crater. I will give it that. Though it is a macro puzzle, so that automatically makes it worse than Crater, but it's still not nearly as bad as Crater. Suck on that paradox. What am I doing? Give ourselves plenty of time. Then walk over here. Give ourselves plenty of time. And then put this here and we start the process. Okay, I think that should be good enough. Let's just hope I did this all right. Where did- oh, it blew, okay. That freaked me out, we still have time. And yes! Wow, I made that just in the nick of time, actually. Okay, we do that, and this, they meet in the middle. And then we just wait on our clone to do its thing. And I am not going to sprint this time, as much as I want to. Oh my gosh, yes! We did it! Ugh. I never, ever want to go back into Eclipse, ever again. Okay, that didn't take too long. Good. We got the box. That means we have two remaining puzzles. I hate Eclipse. Really, I just hate the macro puzzles. These are by far the most challenging macro puzzles I've come across. And I still don't know what I'm supposed to do to get the star in, this guy. With, these things. I thought I just had to do them all in order, but clearly I'm under some kind of time limit. And I refuse, I outright refuse on principle to do puzzles with a time limit. This one made the least sense. Let's go to this one. Like, when we looked at it before, this one didn't make any sense at all, so... now, at least there's no macro recorder in this one. Oh, we can actually jump up there. How was I supposed to know that? Alright, well. We're up high now. I like being up high. Did I- That sounds like I like being a pie, but I actually like being up high. Not in real life, though, but in this game, being up high is quite fun. And... interesting. Oh, well. So much for that. I don't really see how we could do anything useful that way anyway, because these do have pretty high walls. Yeah, whatever, okay. You know, I wonder... what is the thing in here that disables this? I think it's against that wall there, which means I can't really access it right this second. But... yeah, yeah, it's right there. Huh. Oh, you know what? Duh. Da-da-da. Oops. Yeah, I can't do anything up there. Now we can get in here and do whatever we want. We never need to go back in there again. Oh, didn't we... That's right. Hmm. So what's the deal with this again? Does it just alternate? Can I join y'all? No? Unfortunately, it seems not. I think I'm an idiot. I just realized something really obvious. I can do that. That'll make things a lot easier. Alright. You know what I should have done? Is get it in a better angle. Like maybe... here-ish? Whatever. Give me the fan. We can do it this way too. Okay, so now the question is, what do we do now? There's not really a good way to do things the way I'd like. What am I even trying to do? I don't know what I'm trying to do, I just want this to alternate. How do I get it to alternate? I don't know. I'm gonna have to figure this out next episode. So as always, thank you all for watching. If you hate the sound of my voice, leave a dislike, it's up to you. And I will see you all next time. Goodbye!